love, you best believe I'm in love, L-U-V.
Hello darlings, it's Tess and welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, I am Tess, a rainbow witchy creative mess. Now, this video is going to be something that I don't often do, which is related to clothing. I think I've given you guys a couple of lookbooks before, but nothing that sort of focus obsessively on an outfit. Oh wait, no, that's wrong. I did one for my costumes for the Jane Austen Regency dance ball that I went to. That was fun. But in terms of more normal clothes, I haven't really had one outfit in a video deeply devoted to it. But this time I will, because there's a particular outfit that is one of my, like, thrift goals for the year. So, it all comes from a top that my mum actually bought, and that one was really good quality. She just happened not to wear it for some reason. And so I stole it one day, because it just seemed like the right idea. And I wore my knee-high black boots, and we all know that knee-high black boots are very 60s style. But I could barely get them on then, and I can barely get them on now, because I bought them when I was probably 16. And then I actually wore it again for one of my very first TikTok videos that I made, that was like outfits I would wear as a time traveler or something, like clothes that I already had that looked a certain way, that I could go to a time period and then fit in. And so that was my 60s one, and I want to wear it because I think it's cute. I also need knee-high boots, because the ones I had before when I was young, I was a sprinter, which again is impossible to believe, but I was good at it at the end of primary school, beginning of high school. And in the end, I stopped doing it because I just didn't like it anymore, and I didn't want to just force myself to do something that made me miserable. But my sprinter's calves have remained all of these years later. So those boots were just, they barely came on, and I know that I had to get rid of them, and they had just served their purpose for a very long time. And so now, what I'm looking for, longer story longer, these are my thrift goals for 2024. I really want to find them, and I know that it's going to be difficult to find a skirt the exact shade that also fits me, because my waist is quite big. Uncontrollable weight gain from life-saving, irreplaceable medication is just such a fun thing, isn't it? Isn't it? It's going to be even harder to find knee-high boots that fit, because I've got the big calves. It's probably going to take about 2,000 years to find what I need, probably the boots most of all. And that's a shame, because this outfit is actually like really summery, like it's like as you saw before with it. So this is gonna be a very unfast fashion-y outfit, which I'm very excited about. The main part of it, the best part of it, is a hand-me-down from my mom. It's a little big on me because she has bigger shoulders, but I don't care. Obviously, I'm gonna do whatever I can at thrift stores instead of new stores in order to find that skirt and those boots. So we are making a very specific vintage style, or at least vintage in my opinion, if you're a friggin' dress historian or an aesthetic expert on vintage, then feel free to yell at me in the comments. But it just, and whether it's 60s or not, I just like it. So These are my goals. This is right at the beginning of 2024. I literally am, it's the first of January today. So we're gonna see how it goes. I was just rummaging in my wardrobe to find shoes, and I saw the skirt that I have been talking about. It's a very cool kind of bluey purple. So when put with this, I just think it looks really cool, does it not? All right, now we're going to thrift. Okay, update, 1st of January. Didn't find anything in terms of clothing, but I did drop into our local $2 shop that does sell a few decent craft supplies. So I got this, and I've also got another bottle because I'm... So I've just made the decision that at this point, from the number of white skirts that I was seeing, not that any of them fit, but because of the number of white skirts I was seeing, I should definitely be on the lookout for them as much as purple skirts, because like I've dyed things before, like it's really not, I know how to do it, and I would rather have the purple skirt sooner so I can actually wear it in summer. So that way getting white and getting dye might be the way to go. But yes, anyway, day one, no success on boots and skirt, but yes, success on dye. Oh my God. So it is the 2nd now, 2nd of January. I went out thrifting again today. And so you remember how I was whining at absolute length about how it was gonna take 5 million years to find tall boots that would fit my big calves? Hello, 2nd of January. And the thrift goal of the year that I thought would take forever and great frustration and great tears has already been accomplished. 2nd of Jan, second day of the year, and we got it. Good morning, hey, hi, hello, and welcome back to this DIY thrift 1960s let's make an outfit video. As you can see, we have got a bit of an update. Number one, I'm updated here. The last time I spoke to you, my hair was still long. Now it is not. It is the 28th of February today. So I've been looking around for my various bit that I wanted for this outfit, which was bottoms, either shorts or a skirt. And the skirt front proved to be a failure. Like I could not find a skirt that I wanted, whether it would be the purple shade I wanted or white. So I just gave up and went for shorts. So these are the shorts I thrifted. I do unfortunately think they are a fast fashion brand that doesn't but anyway, so I've got these and I want to wear them with my outfit, obviously. And so today we're gonna get to dyeing them, and I'm gonna dye them a ridiculous shade of purple, because if I follow the instructions on the bottle that I've used before, the item actually comes out looking quite light purple, and this time I want it to be like punch in the face purple. Like I want it to be ridiculous. So that's what we're gonna be doing. Most of the time for something that's relatively small, you use kind of a drippy drop of this in the water. No, I'm gonna be using the whole thing. Just for security, I might even use half of this. So yeah, we're really going for it. All right, soup's on. No, I'm kidding. Okay, so I've done this before. I've actually done it to this t-shirt specifically. This came in white and I was like, no, no, no. And I got this long before the TV show went to hell. Hot, and make sure it stays hot.
I could go to a Dune press tour room and have Timothy Chalamet and Austin Butler stick their fingers in the pot. That'll keep it hot. Shake it like a Polaroid picture.
I just need to find our cup measure in order to measure the salt. Can I find it anywhere? Of course not. See, now I'm just hearing Mrs. Patmore. Put the salt into the thing before I grow old and die. Alright, it's the moment of truth. Alright, goodbye whites! In you go! And now to stand here for approximately 30 to 60 minutes. Alright, lordy me, I took the pot off the thing, and obviously I needed two hands, so that's why I'm showing you now. And now I've been running cold water over this, because obviously it was like the hot temperature of the water before, and I obviously like picked it up like that for a second to move it, but it was still the hot water temperature, and I was like, oh, that was clever, Tess. So anyway, this is the color, and obviously I don't want it to be this dark when it's all rinsed out, but the thing about dye is that when it's wet, it looks miles darker. When it's fresh dyed, rather, and wet, it looks miles darker. So I don't want it to be princess purple. Like, I don't want it to be purple the way this is. Like, I want it to be, like, properly purple. So I'm gonna stand here and I'm gonna have to rinse it for 500 years, and that's gonna be really boring to film, so I will catch you after that. You guys, y'all, the shorts have now been drying overnight, but I just have to show you them now because I'm too excited. How freaking perfect are they? Wasn't sure when I was dying. I was like, you know, did I do them too dark? But now that I'm seeing them in the light, yay, they are in the light, I know that I did it right.
I'm in love, you best believe I'm in love, L-U-V.
Yeah.
dancing.